Hey guys, I'm back with another Iron Man 2 review, and today I'm doing the Iron Man 2 Concept Series Advanced Tactical Armor 3-Pack. If you live in the U.S., it's a Kmart exclusive. If you don't live in the U.S., I have heard some stores do carry it. I don't really know. But basically, you're getting the movie series War Machine painted in this kind of military green kind of look. You get the Mark VI painted in what I'm going to call the Patriot Armor, but it's being called the Vibranium Armor. And I also mentioned that War Machine is called the Omega Factor Armor. And then you get the Mark V with, I think that's the Hypervelocity Shield / Missile Launcher. Hard to say slash. And it's being called the Iron Man Mark V Biometal Armor. That's really about it for these guys in terms of packaging. When you get these guys, though, inspect the paint detailings as much as you can. I went through six of these, and these were the best looking ones. And even though my Iron Patriot still has a little silver gash on his chest, it looks like the War Machine is going to have some problems on his wrists. So hope that's nothing really big, but inspect these guys so much. A common thing I saw was that the Iron Patriot, as I'm going to keep calling him for whatever reason, has a lot of smudges on his head, and the paint detailing on this guy was very meh. So let's open it up. And to start off, here is the Omega Factor version of War Machine. Exact same figure. I remember seeing an interview where the person mentioned that his arm articulation was different in some manner. I cannot find any differences in anything with him, aside from his color. Here is the original War Machine with the weapon modification that I did. Nothing major. You can see how the colors are different. I would have liked this guy had different markings on him. This, you know, they have the exact same detailings. The ED405001, all that stuff. I would have liked if they had something different. But sadly, it's all very the same. Definitely not bad looking, though. I think with this guy, since he's not movie version War Machine, to some extent, I have a problem leaving the giant cannon on him just because it's like the, you know, worst case stereotype deal. He still does come with the little ammo belt. It fits to some extent, but it still pops out very easily. I've tried both guns, and it's not much of an improvement. I think you're better off just leaving it out unless you're going to glue it in place. They both still rotate forward. This one holds on a lot more than the original. I forgot to mention the original. The ball joint was very, very loose and it really feels secure. This one, no problem at all. It actually works rather nicely. And he does come with a orange translucent missile that you can put in his little dingy-doo. So, it's time. He's not bad looking. I gotta admit, he's not bad. So, out of the way. Next is the biometal version of the Mark V armor, and admittedly, the one that I was looking the least forward to. Doesn't really do much for me. The only redeeming aspect of this figure, drop my little flashlight, is that a large part of his body is cast in this red translucent plastic. So it has this nice little look for it. I don't know why it would really help, but it's not a bad touch. I'm a sucker for light piping and all that kind of stuff. Even his shield has all the doodads in it. Now, oddly enough, though, this figure does come with an extra hand still, and it is an exact replica of the original briefcase-holding hand. He doesn't come with the briefcase. He has no reason to really come with this hand, but it's still there. Another accessory for you to lose. But again, pull it off. Exact same thing as... I'm pretty sure it's the Hypervelocity Shield. I'm probably wrong, but that's what I remember. Here he is next to his original version. The black on him really doesn't look too bad, and I possibly could pretend that this is a whole other armor altogether. I don't know why, you know, the Mark V has a purpose of being the portable suit. I don't know why he would need a biometal version of the Mark V unless he decided to upgrade it for some bizarre reason. It's not bad looking. The paint detailing is pretty nice if you get one that's not really banged up. But it's definitely my least favorite of the set. It's just like an add-on type thing. So there are those two. And last but not least is the Vibranium Armor version, or what I'm going to call the Iron Patriot. I've seen some pictures where this is accurate to some Iron Man story. Not specifically the Iron Patriot itself, but this is screen accurate to one version of whatever thing that came from this abomination. I think it just looks really cool, though. I like the shield. Supposedly, this is the regular Marvel Universe Captain America shield. It does come off. It does have the little elastic bands, the little clip. It doesn't clip very well onto his arm. And it does kind of flop around quite a bit, but getting stationary, it looks fine. Shield's always fun to have. Now, the figure itself, sadly, this is what I was looking forward to the most from this set. This is admittedly the one that has the worst amount of quality control on it. There are serious blotches, those little, I'm going to call vents there. Very clean on one side, very blotchy on the other. Whatever that line is, it's paint, but it's not scraping off at all. I don't know what it is. You go on his back here, and you can see it. Not bad, very blotchy. So, it's really hit or miss with these guys. When getting this, it's hard to spot with him because most of his problems are covered up by the shield or that you can't even see what's going on behind the figure. On his own, though, I think he looks pretty cool. Here's next to the original Mark VI, show how they look together, if you care about that kind of thing. Again, articulation is exactly the same with him as it is the Mark VI itself. And the shield, I suppose, if you get it lined up properly, you could probably have him carry it behind his back in some manner, but just gonna go ahead and stick it on his little wrist there. Not clipped in, just enough. And his legs, the packaging, are very, very warped. You may have to tinker with them to get them where he can actually stand. But there you have it. There is the Advanced Tactical Armor 3-Pack. Kmart exclusive. I would say pick it up. It will cost you about $24, $26, depending on tax. But it boils down to about $8 per figure, so you are paying retail price per individual figure. And for me, with the Iron Patriots, I'm going to call it, and the War Machine, those two themselves look fine. This guy, he's grown on me a little bit more, but he's still my least favorite from the set. Overall, they're not shabby, and I think if you are working on a Hall of Armors, like I think most of us are, more armors. Go crazy! Although, it is really worth noting, and this is kind of an add-on that I forgot, none of these guys come with their figure stands, the armor cards, which I think kind of stinks. These guys don't stand too badly, but hit them hard enough, and some are going to fall. You know, what are you going to do? It would have been cool if these guys could have come with figure stands, but since they don't, it's a knockoff the figure itself. But that's it. That's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you have a great day. I will see you around. Take care.